Hi there, this is Adam with Sakari. In this video, we'll walk through how to send out event reminder text messages to multiple recipients. To get started, we need a list of all of our contacts as well as their phone numbers in an Excel file. I've created a sample data set, so let's open that up now. So I have all of my contacts in an Excel file that I want to send the event reminders to. When I'm sending text messages in Sakari, there are only two fields that are required to send the messages. They are the country code and the mobile phone number. But I also want to personalize my messages, so I've included the contact's first name. When I'm saving my file, the first row needs to be the column name. I'll save the file in a CSV format and upload it to create my campaign. So now that we have our data set complete, let's go in and create the campaign. So I'm logged into the Sakari system. In the left navigation, I'll click Campaigns, and I'll create a new campaign by clicking the plus sign. There are three different types of campaigns in Sakari. We have manual, scheduled campaigns, and file upload campaigns. In this case, I'm going to be using our Excel sheet, so I want to select a file upload campaign. When I select that, there are three steps to creating the campaign. The first is field mapping. I'll select field mapping and then upload my file to be able to map the field columns from Excel into the Sakari system. I'll click Next, and we can clean up the data set here. We don't have last names, so we can delete that. We don't have emails, so we can delete that as well. And we don't have tags, so we can delete that. The system is expecting a property name, a first name, but we've actually called it the field first. So let's change that to first, and we can delete the first column, and now we have all of our fields mapped. So we can save this now. The next step is to create our template. We'll select Design Template and start typing our message. In this example, I want to personalize each message to the recipient with their first name, so I'll say hi, add the at sign, which will select from our available drop-down fields, and select first name. This will automatically pull in the first name from our file and personalize each text message. This is a reminder about the birthday bash this Friday night. This looks good, so I'll click Save. The final step is just to select whether or not you want the optional reporting. In this case, I don't care about that, so I'll just select No and Save. So now I can give this a name, and I'll call this the Birthday Bash Reminder. I'll click Save, and now I'm ready to send my campaign. To execute your campaign, I can click the blue Execute button to the right and drag our file over. The system will automatically recognize the number of rows from the file, and we can click Upload to send our messages. The messages are now being processed. If I want to get a status report, I can expand the campaign and click the reporting icon for the execution that I'm interested in. I'll click this icon here, and we can already get a sense of the messages that have gone out and the replies that have come in. I can see each of the outgoing messages by clicking the Outgoing tab, and see how each has been personalized to each of the contacts. We can also see any responses that have come in by clicking on the Incoming tab. Here we've set this up with some auto responses to be able to illustrate what it looks like when a response has come in. If I want to respond to one of these contacts, I can click the Reply button to be able to respond specifically to that contact, either here or on the Conversations page. Let's take a look at the Conversations page. I'll click Conversations in the left navigation, and we can see that the system has automatically opened up a conversation for each of the contacts that we've sent an invitation to. When they reply, that row will be highlighted in blue. I've sent one of these text messages to myself. To see that, I can drag my phone over, open up the message, and we can see the personalized text message. I can respond to it, and and in real time that'll be pushed back to the Sakari system. We can see that reflected on the conversations page, where Adam has responded with "see you then." If I'd like to respond on top of that, I can click the blue send message button and say, "sounds great." And in real time, create a two-way conversation with my contacts.